You can use the same sleeves the best players in the world use, Channel Fireball sleeves. And what better way to carry them than in a Channel Fireball deck box? And if you want to play like the best, you have to dress like the best. Channel Fireball shirts, hats, hoodies, and more are all available in the apparel section of ChannelFireball.com. Head to ChannelFireball.com/store to find all of your gaming supplies.
Hey everyone, welcome to a cube draft. Oh my, look at what we have here. We have a Grim Monolith. Very sweet because it's very quick mana acceleration. Generally lets you do broken things like play Titans really early, Broodmate Dragons, whatever. Very scary stuff. Other good cards are Tanglewire because it usually gives you enough free turns when you're an aggro deck to make it so that you get a lot of free wins. It makes it very difficult for the opponent to play spells. Volcanic Island is also pretty good. The original cycle of dual lands are very good with fetch lands because it lets you cast almost anything with by virtue of having fetch lands. Fetch lands, dual lands, which is a classic combination, really opens up a wide variety of deck or deck types. But yeah, we're just going to go ahead and take this monolith. Other stuff like Venser, Thrun, Progenitus are like, okay, Venser's not bad, but doesn't really have as much potential as Grim Monolith. Now here we have got some stuff. We have Thran Dynamo, which being this from the same era as Grim Monolith, although it's not nearly as broken because it costs twice as much, although you do get 3 mana every single turn as opposed to just once, but still pretty good. Boreal is pretty good, but it's on the very, very bottom of the green one drops because it produces colorless mana. And, you know, Birds of Paradise and Jorah Chief Speaker at the top. I think for now we're just going to take the Dynamo and keep our options open. We do have Greater Gargadon and Mystical Tutor, which are both pretty combo-y cards that let you do pretty tricky things, especially with like balance and upheaval. But for now, we're just going to take that guy. Okay, so what do we have here? We've got some stuff. We have Avenger of Zendikar. I think it's my favorite green finisher. He just puts so much power into play. It creates a just giant roadblock. It's awesome. Generally not the creature you want to accelerate out into just because you're not going to be getting a bunch of 1-1s. But still good nonetheless. Other good cards include Oracle, which is, you know, pretty good with shuffle effects or draw effects. Basically, spells or effects that let you rearrange the top of your deck, like Sensei's Divining Top, Jace, etc., etc. Lets you do some really tricky stuff with this guy. You can put all of your bad lands back on top, play those lands, and all of a sudden you have spells. So we're going to stick with Avenger. I do like Faithless Looting and Sower, but Avenger is pretty good, especially when you already have a bunch of ramp. And here the best card is Grave Titan, just because it's like similar to Avenger in that it puts a lot of power into play and it hits for a lot. It's just one of the more difficult cards that I've found that Black can throw out there. Other cards that are good are Verdant Catacombs, Polluted Delta. Hopefully the Catacombs wheels, especially with this color, the first four picks that we've got. But the other cards are not terribly interesting. Looter can be good with reanimating, and generally good with filtering. Birthing Pod is generally difficult to use because you don't have enough Enter the Battlefield triggers and a reasonable curve to support that, like with Water Elements and whatnot. Charlotte's Agent can be okay. But if you have a bunch of counter spells, then it ends up not being that great. You need stuff with, like Water Elements for it to be good. And Nice Whisper is just kind of meh. Oh my. So, here, got some blue cards. Regrowth's an option. We have Wooded Foothills an option. That would work out, assuming we're green. If we're not green, then Wooded Foothills ends up being pretty mediocre. And the best, the most powerful card is Ravages of War. Just because, yeah, Armageddons are pretty effective. Turns out, who knew? Other options, don't really want to take Force of Will just yet. I would be more inclined to take Seagate Oracle or Preordain. And of those, I would prefer Seagate Oracle, just because I generally like doing stuff with creatures. Just because there are a lot of effects that benefit you from having them, like Opposition, Trade and Writer, Sivan Shapeshifter, all that nonsense. So I think we'll go ahead and take the Seagate Oracle. It's pretty close between that and Woodfoot Hills, but I think I want to keep my options open. And let's see. We have Grim Monolith, which isn't as good as Basalt Monolith with this guy, but still not bad. The option of taking that or Tragic Slip seems like it's going to be the case. And don't know if I'm blue-green or blue-black at this point. It seems like both are blue and green are, this is more likely going to be the combination, just because we've got Trigon Predator, Bant Charm. I think I'm just going to take this Wake Thrasher and be done with it. Alternatively, could just take All's Dust, but I think I would rather take Wake Thrasher so that if we see a Basalt Monolith, we can snatch it up and go for a little combo kill. And yeah, it looks like blue is open, so I think we'll just go ahead and take Essence Scatter or Dungeon Geist. One of those two. I'm more of a fan of Dungeon Geist because it's I don't like my counters to be too situational, although Essence Scatter at 2 mana is usually pretty good. But I mean, this is going to be able to play the board a bit better. I'd rather just have solid counter spells. So I think we'll just take that. And, yep, looks like green is not going to happen, so that'll let us keep this open as for in case we want to go with some sort of reanimator strategy, and we might end up wheeling that Luteral Core, although it's the only blue card in the pack, so that's not necessarily going to be what ends up playing out. But between Tendrils and Vampire Nighthawk, I would rather have the Nighthawk simply because we don't really have a way of playing with a lot of swamps other than Urborg, and we're not necessarily going to see that, so I'd rather take that than the Mazebeth. Okay, so here we can take Undead Gladiator into the Royal. They're both they can be okay. Gladiator lets us do a few more things. I think I want to try and go with the Gladiator since we have the Avenger. It plays out a little bit better. I do like Into the Royal, but I think the Gladiator is going to be a little bit better in this case, just because we might not want to be playing with a Wake Thrasher in a certain game, and so having the option of turning that into a real card is going to be somewhat useful. And here, I mean, we can keep our green hopes alive. We do have, I mean, Grave Titan is pretty much the only green card that I actively want to play. And Thawing Glaciers is usually pretty slow. So I think we'll just take Call of the Herd. I don't really see Thawing Glaciers being a card that we're going to play, whereas it's possible that we end up playing Call if we end up green. And we've got a creature removal and Hinder. I'm going to take Hinder just because we don't have any counter spells, and we have Dungeon Geist and Nighthawk and Grave Titan. Those are both pretty good at handling creatures, so we'll just take the counterspell. And we can take the Night's Whisper or Mystic Gate. We don't have any white spells at the moment, so we'll go ahead and take Night's Whisper. Not the best, but it's still a draw too. And we can take Terminus or Regrowth. Probably going to take the Regrowth just in case we end up going some sort of bug combo. I don't really see us playing Bant. And here we can take one of the two. Well, Bant Charm. And Hailmar Depths. I suppose we'll end up playing that depending on getting any fetch lands. So overall, looks okay, not great. I mean, we do have some busted mana acceleration, which is good. Do a quick cost sort. Got 2, 3, 4. So our curve isn't that high. And I would say that overall, this is pretty sort of average to slightly below average in terms of the spells that I want. Yeah, and obviously this pack, we open up all of the blue or green cards. So I think I'm going to take this Drock Tree Speaker and Hedge on playing green. Just getting a ton of green this pack and getting rid of either blue or black. And Forbidden Alchemy is not a card. And the other option would be to take Marsh Flats or Bloodstained Mire. And the upside to that is just pretty insignificant compared to the upside of getting enough green to be able to play Draugr Tree Speaker. And I can only hope that, I have to assume that one of these green cards is going to wheel, even the acidic slime. So yeah, I mean, just Draugr Tree Speaker is so good. So we're going to take that. Alright, so there aren't really any good black cards here. Good Let's see, and we've got a few good white cards. Mother Runes and Parallax Wave are both pretty good. So our option is either to take Eternal Witness or we can take Factor Fiction. And I don't really know what if I want to ditch. Assuming we do end up going green, I don't know if I what color I want to ditch. Although, of all of these cards, I think it's more likely that we end up playing, of all the colors rather, I think it's more likely that we end up playing blue, which makes Foff a pretty good pick. Although if we, when this pack comes back, I'm pretty sure that Fathom Seer will, and Repeal will, might be here, but Factor Fiction is not going to be here. So I think I just, actually just want to take Eternal Witness here, because it's a hedge on one of those blue cards coming back. And this pack is pretty much the same case. No black, but we've got a ton of stuff. We have a bunch of mid-range stuff like Moloku, which not too much of a fan of. And then Master of the Wild Hunt, which is also kind of mediocre. Snapcaster Mage, looking at our spells, we have Night's Whisper Regrowth, Call the Herd Hinder, and that's about it. So that's pretty mediocre. There's also, we can take Dissipate, and then hope that one of these cards ends up wheeling, or we can just take Master of the Wild Hunt and go with the same thing that we did sort of last time. And there's the Urborg for the Tendrils that I talked about earlier. I think I'm going to do is just go with the Master, since it's a... we've got a pretty heavy blue pack, and only one green card. Now, this pack is sort of the opposite. I'm not really going to be playing Coral Home Commander, though, in my Tree Speaker deck. I think I'd rather take Natural Order or Natural Order. Let's see. You have to sacrifice a green creature, which can get another green creature. And we don't really have any reason to play Heartbeat because we already have Thrandymo and Grim Monolith and Tree Speaker, and that's enough acceleration. So I think what I'm going to do is just take this Vengeance Reiner Natural Order. And it seems like Natural Order is going to be the most broken of the two, just because Avenger is so good. And if we end up picking up any more green creatures, then that will be fine. Now, this is pretty sweet. We've got Elves of Deep Shadow and Nature's Lore. No dual lands for the Nature's Lore. It puts into a play onto the battlefield untapped, so you can get a Savannah untapped. I think we're just going to go ahead and take this Elves of Deep Shadow, just because I like the one drops. And if we end up playing black, then this will be double on color, whereas this is not necessarily going to be. And here we've got some stuff. No blue, one black card, so looks like this green thing is paying out for this pack. The cards that are not good for us are Flinthoof Boar and Thornscape Battlemage. Then we have Genesis and Blastoderm. Blastoderm's kind of meh. Viper and Genesis are both pretty mediocre, so I think I actually just want to go with Plowunder, especially since we have Eternal Witness. Plowunder is like okay, but these creatures just really aren't too impressive, so, and I'm pretty sure one of them is going to wheel. We've got 9 cards left. Well, there'll be 2 cards left when we see the pack, so it's probably going to be like, yeah, I think that'll be one green card. Hopefully it's not one of these two. So we'll just take the Plowunder. And Thelonite Hermit, pretty good with Natural Order if we can flip this guy. Other cards including Exploration. We don't really have the Thawing Glaciers, which was last pack, so we'll go ahead and take the Hermit. And the other option is take Relic, but don't really see playing that. I'd much rather just play the Hermit. Tinker. Well, we've got a few artifacts. Nothing busted yet, so I think I'll just take the Vigilante. Having ways to blow up artifacts and enchantments is pretty good. So, Vigilante is an okay one. I generally prefer Acidic Slime and Yavimaya Coast. Not the worst. Better than Marsh Flats for our case. Hopefully we don't have to play this, because it's a pain land. But it's going to be better than, probably than Forbidden Alchemy, since at this point I don't really see us playing any of these black cards. So we'll just go ahead and take the Coast. And as you can see, Fathom Seer and Misdirection are both there. No one's playing white, because those are two really good white cards, and they're both still in the pack after the wheel. see. So between Fathom Seer and Misdirection, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 blue cards. So Misdirection's probably not going to be that great. Similarly, Fathom Seer is also not that great, but it does draw cards, which is not the worst. And we can just take this Dissipate here. I don't really want to play Force Spike. It's a little too narrow. I would prefer to play Spell Pierce. And then Dissipate and Hinder. I think I want to take the Heartbeat because we may not have enough, depending on what our blue sources look like, our mana base, we might need to be able to use Heartbeat as a way to generate double blue. So yeah, this pack was kind of mediocre. We can take the Sanction Grudge. And Murmuring Bosk, I think. There's no way that we're playing Blastoderm. So hopefully green is open for this next pack. We didn't wheel any of the acceleration from the pack that we opened. And we have, some stuff, but this is not really a good deck at the moment.